Hi Aquarius, welcome to Mirakya the Tribe. My name is Ayushi and I'm bringing you your November 2018 reading. This is going to be for the sign of Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising. And let's see what's coming up for Aquarius for the month of November 2018, Sun, Moon and Rising. What are the messages coming in for Aquarius for November 2018, Sun, Moon and Rising? What are the messages coming in for Aquarius, Sun, Moon and Rising for November 2018? 10 card Celtic Cross. 10 card Celtic Cross. Okay. First card out for you is Daughter of Wands, which is a card where someone is very determined to carry out their plans and dreams and ideas. This person is very determined in a way that they will not settle for anything less. When it comes to their plans or dreams or passions, they pursue them wholeheartedly. They do not slack basically, and they give it their all, and until unless they have achieved their goal, they are not going to settle down. And this is the bottom of the deck, so this can be in a relationship as well, where you want to pursue someone that you find attractive, like a Leo, Sagittarius or Aries. This card represents those signs, Sun, Moon, Rising. But it can be anyone whom you find very physically attractive and charismatic. So you might be feeling mutual attraction towards this person. Let's see what's coming up. And the person that you're dealing with probably is someone who is very focused on their passions, and they want to really live their dreams. So they are working on that. Okay. So your first card is the Empress. You could be dealing with a Taurus person. It's crossed by Six of Pentacles. Your root energy is the High Priestess. And your past energy is Five of Wands. Your crowning energy is Nine of Swords. Your future energy is Sun of Cups. Your own energy is Judgment. Energy surrounding you is Ten of Swords. Your hopes and fears is Ace of Cups. Your outcome is Ace of Wands. So two aces, three major arcanas, and two cards which are related to betrayal and overthinking. And overall energy is the Sun of Swords. So guys, what I see here is that okay, I'm just gonna say it like I feel that there is someone who is very giving. Excuse me for the train. Okay, so there is someone very giving in a relationship or just as a whole. This person is very abundant and they can offer a lot. This can be your mother as well, or someone who is a motherly figure who cares for the other person without expecting anything in return, or this person doesn't need anything, they have a lot to offer themselves. So this person can be very nurturing, and you could also be dealing with a Pisces person, a Scorpio person, Cancer person, and Leo, Aries, Sag, and I get here someone like Aquarius or Libra or Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising. But majorly water sign, fire sign, and Taurus. So, what I'm getting here is that on your mind, you're thinking about something over and over again. You are stuck on something, and you are thinking about a situation or an idea or someone, and killing yourself basically because you're thinking so much. Like you're up at night thinking about this over and over and over again, and. It can be that when if you were dealing with someone, you gave a lot to that person, and that person did not return much of what you did for them, and that is because Six of Pentacles is the challenging card, so not equal give and take. So there has been some clashes when it comes to you not receiving your dues that is coming up, and then you know something that is secret. Or a hidden knowledge, or you just know something out of your intuition, and your intuition is telling you that someone has betrayed you, and they might have as well betrayed you, or you have betrayed them. But this person is probably also coming to you for second chance, because you have to decide if you want to give this person a second chance or not, or this is you who is asking for a second chance, and the other person that you are dealing with is feeling very betrayed by you, and you want to make it to up to them. Something of that is coming up here. Whatever it is, you hope that there will be new love or starting of something new, but that is also your fear that someone will find new love outside this relationship that you were sharing with somebody. In past, I see that there was some clash when it comes to other people, and there were some ideas that were floating around, and something was scattered like a energy, or you were distracted in past. But right now, you really want to offer somebody something emotional. Or something emotional is approaching you, like somebody is offering you love, new love basically, and it can be a person from the past, but it can also be that you are still stuck on your past and you are not able to see the beauty of new love that is coming your way. So this is in November, okay, because I won't suggest you to start anything new till the 16th of November, because Venus is in retrograde. However, your outcome is the Ace of Wands, so I'm getting that whatever it is, it's very emotional, pure, and passionate. Look at these two cards, two aces. At the same time, you're very scared of whatever this is. You are not feeling very. I'm getting that you want to be playful, but something is holding you back. Maybe you know that you have a lot and you can be self-sufficient. At the same time, you want to experience something new, but you still are feeling very betrayed from something that happened in the past. There was some competition between people that is coming up here, and when it comes to forgiving yourself or the other person, I don't know if you will be able to do it, but it is suggested that you do forgive whoever that you were dealing with, whoever you are thinking about right now, who has probably betrayed you, and you are overthinking about this situation and you are driving yourself nuts basically. Your overall energy is the Sun of Swords, so there is someone stalking you or you are stalking someone. You are either looking for a right moment to approach somebody, or someone else is looking for a right moment to approach you. And there can be a message that this person is bringing, but they might not give you that message if they feel that you are not in a right place or you are not ready to listen. Something of that nature is coming. This person, whoever is trying to bring you a message or trying to communicate with you, this person can be really blunt, and they might even hurt you with their words or how they communicate with you. They are not very good with communication basically. And then Eight of Wands with Lovers and Magician. and then justice. So there can be someone who is traveling or who is far away from you, or who is traveling towards you, or you are traveling towards this person, or you are trying to send message to this person and you are hoping for a reply and a communication. Things are moving and you have to probably make a decision if you want to be committed to this person or not. It can be a person, it can be a job as well, or it can be a certain type of lifestyle. You have all the resources. If you if you look within, you will find yourself with tremendous power and resources. And also I'm getting that you have a karmic balance right now, like you have balanced the karma. Things are in balance, and if you were giving something to someone and it was not being reciprocated, you have to fix that. You cannot keep giving and giving and expect the other person to not give as much as you are giving them. It can also go the other way, like the other person has been giving you a lot of attention and lot of nurturing, but you are not expressive. And this is your reading where it's being suggested that you need to start afresh and give it a second chance and be expressive this time, because the person is the other person is feeling very betrayed by you. So that was a reading, and I'll pull out a card from this Sacred Rebel deck. This is for Aquarius. By the way, by the month of November, you are very excited, very spirited. You are enthusiastic and you want to pursue something with a lot of enthusiasm, and there is some idea and a dream that you want to pursue, and it like something has come into your mind which you want to start building upon. I'm also seeing that some of you are researching over something, and you are trying to build something. Okay, like I said, you are trying to bring something. The card that's come out for you is bring it into form. So this is the card that I was seeing, and I was telling you that you are seeing something that you want to bring into reality, and you want to bring some ideas into reality. Even if you are passionate about someone, you want to make it concrete, you want to take action upon it. And your bottom of the deck card is every step, every journey starts with a single step. So definitely some movement is required here, like you need to start making moves. So one blockage card. Okay, it fell. I'm getting that your intuition is very strong, and you can trust your intuition, basically, Aquarius, in the month of November. What is blockage for Aquarius? Some of you are working too hard and not giving yourself a break. So there needs to be some creative break, and if you are working at night, pushing yourself to discover something or solving a mystery, I'm getting, then you need to give yourself some break. And completion, there is some cycle that has come to an end, and you need to process that, and you need to start something new now, because something that you were working on or dealing with has come to a full circle. So yes, so that was your reading, Aquarius. I hope you got your messages that you needed. I'll see you next month. Take care.